Gosh, go away from the kids.
No, Greg!
Claire, show us your top.
Beg your pardon. Mrs. Marlowe.
Mrs. Marlowe? You know those little boxes that you had? Those two, those. The tiny little ones.
Oh, yes, I've got in the box on the table in the kitchen, there is a cake stand which is just one tiered. And I was going to do sort of like a pyramid effect. So you've got the white and then the red at the top.
Yeah.
And there is a few Love Heart chocolates. They were
in the dining room.
But can I finish them all?
Right, okay, yes. But you've got Love Heart sticks as well.
Oh, have we?
Yeah.
Oh, just a few, maybe just a few scattered around it, really. But I don't even know where we'd put that.
Well, the only thing I was going to say, which
is at the end of the
table. In between. You know, in between, yeah, you could have it.
Oh, are they dirty?
We need nine on there.
That's nice, well done. Is that going to stay?
I think we could ask Angela to add a little bit of greenery to the top.
Oh, I quite like it, just black and green. It looks very dinner party,
no,
doesn't
like
it?
It.
Do they?
Yeah.
Where are we going to... Where did you want another place?
Oh, I just want
one more place set in, please. Oh, they're not in
the annex. They're not in the
annex. No, I just wondered, because they are quite heavy, aren't
that
they?
That would be a bit of a
disaster. That would be a little bit, wouldn't it? Yeah. It'd be like a Greek wedding, wouldn't it?
Overplated.
Two more, please.
And then just two, please.
Hello.
How are you?
I just realised.
I'm not going to do that.
Can you say to Uncle Tom, can he remember to video Chris's speech for me?
I am going to video.
Oh, okay, you video it then, darling. You're right, Paul.
I guess he's doing a
given type of thing. The other week,
Oh, sorry. I've been filmed.
Thank you. Just like a star crossed my sky, just like an angel off the page, you have appeared to my life. Feel like I'll never be the same. Just like a song in my heart, just like oil on my hand. All I want to love you. Still I won't know why it is. I don't know you like this with anyone but you. We do it all the time, blowing out my mind. You've got the secret heart described. You made me feel I'm alive. When everything else is okay, without a doubt you're on my side. Heaven has been away too long. I'll find the words to write this song. Oh, your love. Still I wonder why it is. Blowing out my mind. Yeah, da 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 da. But we've been through that before. From tonight I know that you're the only one. I've been confused and in the dark. Now I understand. Yeah. Oh.
No, I'm going to take a picture.
Mum, go take the photo.
Could you?
I'm going to film it.
I'm going to go. Jerry, come with me. I'm
going to go.
There's a square box in the piano room.
Yes,
in the piano room.
Very serious with your videoing, Chris.
Well, you're right. Do you just push or do you just stay there and not?
We've been started.
Oh. No, so it's going. I'll fade out now.
Okay, yeah.
I'm going to go to the hospital.
car they've got, Karen and I know, it's beautiful, isn't it?
They're very vintage. Oh, yeah. She says, so now, isn't it?
Oh, look at Minnie.
I don't know if I saw all the photographs, but oh, look at Esther, what an old bag. Seriously, he's doing a video, picture. Darling.
Did you know about the caricature of you when you arrived?
I ordered it, darling.
Ladies and gentlemen. I think we've all been enjoying ourselves, but unfortunately, all good things have to come to an end. It's time for the kitchen. I'd like to start by thanking you all for coming here today to celebrate the marriage of Claire and Adrian. I know it means an awful lot to both of them that you can be here today. I'd particularly like to thank those who have travelled over from Ireland to be with us today. We appreciate the effort that you've made, Peggy, Maura and Michael, Teresa and Patricia, Anne and Bernadette and Marie, so thank you.
James Stan.
I'd also like to say how honoured I was to be asked by Claire to give her away. It made me very proud and I'd like to thank you for asking me. I'm not sure, however, that I have read the small print, which said that by accepting, I was also picking up the tab for the wedding. On that point, it's clearly sad that neither of Claire's parents, neither Mary nor Joe, is able to be with us here today. I do know, however, that they are with us in a very real sense and will be raising a glass or two in heaven to the happy couple. Now, I'm not sure that Joe would have enjoyed making a Father of the Bride speech, but I'm sure that he and Mary would have been delighted that Claire had married Adrian. Adrian is a kind, considerate guy, a musician, in employment, clean living and fit, a perfect foil for Claire. He enjoys running and tennis like Claire. He clearly values family and family life and is obviously very much in love. Now, if only he was an Irish Catholic, he would have scored 100% on the Mary and Joe checklist. Mind you, he did enjoy helping me castrate one of my bullocks, so maybe there's some Irish blood in there somewhere. And so today we remember Mary and Joe, and also Adrian's dad, Tony, who sadly passed away only 2 years ago, and who I'm sure would have very much enjoyed today. Today, though, is very much about Claire and Adrian. I will leave the tales of Adrian's colourful past for Chris to share with us in his best man's speech, but I'd like to take this opportunity to welcome Adrian to the family. To marry one of the three Quinlivan girls requires a very special kind of man. And Adrian is that very special kind of man. I'm sure that Tom will agree with me that Adrian has got the necessary patience, good humour, tolerance, and general laid-backness, which is the secret of a long and happy marriage to a Quinlivan. So welcome on board, Adrian. We're delighted to welcome you to our family. On the subject of best men, it did strike me as a sign of the times that Claire's hen do was a day at the races, Ascot no less, while Adrian and his stags partook of the viewing of a polo match in Windsor Great Park. Whatever happened to a few beers and a curry? On that note, I know that Claire would like me to thank Fiona for organising her hen do, which by all accounts was a very, very special day. And what of Claire?
Dun, dun.
Claire is a multifaceted woman. And this is reflected in her wide range of aliases. When I first met Claire, she would sign postcards and birthday cards Clara, which I suppose is at least similar to Claire. She and Caroline, in fact Adrian as well, are members of Whitchmore Hill Tennis Club, hence Serena and Venus. Not sure which is which though. She is the self-styled Victorian nanny, trying to install some discipline, with some success, into her nieces and nephews. She has been Paula, which is hopefully a reference to her marathon running, rather than to relieving herself in a gutter. Ruby is her skivvying persona, a nod to the servant in the TV programme Upstairs, Downstairs. In another TV reference, her boss, hi Tony, calls her Fizz, who I'm assured works in a factory on Coronation Street. Bridezilla, I believe, requires no explanation. And if someone could explain the name Pup, I would be very grateful. Often though her name changed, her hair has changed at least as regularly. Mohican, skinhead, long, short, white, ginger, which itself changed its name to strawberry blonde. In fact, if I ever dig out my wedding photos, the first comment isn't, doesn't Caroline look beautiful? It's not even, doesn't Andy look handsome? It's, oh my God, what did Claire do to her hair? I can honestly say though, today, Claire's hair, along with the rest of her, looks absolutely beautiful. I'm sure we all agree. The Quinlivans have always been close. I know that Caroline spoke to her mother most days and speaks to Claire and Jerry pretty much every day. Claire has become an important part of our life here in Bishop Stortford. And I think that in many ways, our friends have become her friends, which is why I think so many of them were so keen to help out on her big day. So on behalf of Claire and the guests, can I thank you for your hard work? Yeah, that's you lot over there. I am going to run through them by name, I'm afraid. So, for John and Gary, and Brian in the bar. Now, Brian, I don't know if you've heard, sold a business this week for quite a lot of money. So, really, he and his wife should be celebrating in, I don't know, some posh hotel somewhere. But instead, he's here serving you. Aww. Jane, Debbie, Jane, Claire, Judith, Christina, Eileen, Paula, Anna and Mandy, have I forgotten the name? Louise, and Christian, the photographer, who I think has probably got another career. Already people have tried to book him. In his day job, he works in the city, honest. Seriously though, I mean, I know that we have been moved by, you know, the love that you've shown us through giving up your time, and I know that Caroline's mascara has run at least once thinking about, you know, what you've done for us. So thank you very, very much. What else of Claire? Well, what more could you wish for? She's fiercely loyal to her friends. I think it's a testament to that fierce loyalty that so many of her friends here today have been close to her for 20 or 30 years. While Claire has never been accused of not knowing how to enjoy herself and have a good time, there is another side to her personality. A steely determination, a capacity for hard work, an ability to focus on the task in hand, an eye for spotting what needs to be done without being asked. Don't forget that she went abroad to work after school, which requires a degree of bravery. Don't forget that she studied for and passed her degree while holding down a full-time job. Don't forget that she has run not one, but two marathons. She's an open and warm person, genuinely interested in others, but there is an immensely strong core there too. There's actually a strong body there too. I remember at Caroline and my wedding, a fight broke out, and we'll have none of that here later, thank you. And while my ushers were beginning to think about looking for each other in order to have a chat about making a plan to contain the violence, there was a flash of blue, the colour of Caroline's bridesmaids' dresses, as Claire and Jerry steamed in and broke it up. Clearly those nights working in some of the pubs on the Holloway Road have proved useful. Before I sit down, I would like to put on record my often hidden admiration for Caroline, my wife, who has taken on much of the burden of organising the celebrations today. It's a task that she has willingly, I was going to say accepted, but seized by me a more accurate description. But nevertheless, it has been a monumental task in a relatively short period of time, done to a budget, and you have carried it off fantastically and mainly good-humouredly. So well done you. Still the apple of my eye. Ladies and gentlemen, it's always a pleasure to attend a wedding. They say the world loves a lover, and I think that's true. Marriage is an expression of love, and also the start of a lifelong adventure. As Niels Bohr, the Danish physicist, once observed, prediction is never easy, particularly about the future. However, I'm willing to stick my neck out and say that this marriage between Claire and Adrian, only 3 days long, will be a long and happy and strong one. So please charge your glass, stand up if able, and toast the bride and groom.
I can't.
I now hand you over to your groom, Adrian Marlowe.
Well, thanks, Andy. So how do you follow that? Well, I'll try my hardest. Firstly, the advantage of having a wedding over 2 days is that I have an opportunity for a dress rehearsal for my speech, which we had on Thursday. Huh? And of course it also gave Claire the opportunity to censor out anything that she didn't like. But basically it's the same speech as I gave on the Thursday, or very similar. So for those that were there on Thursday, I do apologise. But you'll have to sit through it again. So, firstly, thanks. Thanks to Andy for giving Claire away on Thursday. And also, again, thanks to Jerry, Tom, Caroline and Andy for all their hard work and generosity in laying on the wedding reception on Thursday at Hanbury Manor. And also this lovely reception today. I'd also like to thank, thank you. Thank you. I'd also like to thank all you, the guests, for attending today. It's fantastic to see you all, and we're very grateful that you could all make it to share our day with us today, so thank you. Thank you all for your gifts and your well wishes as well. I'd like to thank my mum and Chris and Laura for their assistance and contributions towards our wedding as well. So thank you to you. I'd like to thank the bridesmaids who took part on Thursday and who are here today, sitting over there. They looked wonderful on Thursday, and I think you'll agree that they still look wonderful today. And thank you for your contributions. And thank you also to Rebecca, who sang for us today beautifully. So thank you very much. Yeah, just over there, yeah. And also, again, I'd like to thank all that team of people that have helped us today and over the last few days and weeks. It's an absolute tremendous effort, and we do really appreciate it. It's quite breathtaking what you've done and your commitment to our day to day. So I do thank you from the top of my heart. So thank you. So the wedding on Thursday. As you probably know, we got married at Hanbury Manor, and it was a wonderful, lovely, sunny day, a bit like today. Everything went really smoothly. And it's in a lovely setting, and both Claire and I do feel very lucky that we were able to be married in such a wonderful place. And so again, thank you very much for laying that on for us. And also today, for this wonderful reception today, and special thanks to Andy and Caroline for allowing us to use their beautiful home for our wedding reception. It's just made it feel so much more enjoyable and so much more relaxing. So thank you very much once again for that. Claire and I got engaged in June this year, and we had a relatively short time to plan for the wedding and get all the arrangements made. So Claire and her sisters have done a fantastic job, along with her army of friends, and in getting everything arranged so quickly. Okay, so a few words about the bride, back Claire. Just a few. She told me to shorten this a little bit, but I tried. But I would like to say how beautiful she looks today, and indeed on Thursday as well. I know it's customary to say that, but I really genuinely mean it and believe it. So, Claire is hardworking and genuine, and I consider myself fortunate to have met her. Claire can be very focused and single-minded. yes, there we go. particularly when she has a goal to aim for. As we've already heard, she's run two marathons, numerous half marathons, countless races, fun runs and fundraisers, and has raised thousands of pounds for charity. Claire's single-mindedness, however, sometimes can be a little bit too much for some. And this has led to her nickname, which we did briefly hear about earlier on, as Bridezilla. And I think Claire will herself confess that that on occasions that's probably been a deserved nickname. But I'll leave that there. okay, our romance. Moving on. Claire and I met for the first time at our local running club one Thursday evening just over 2 years ago. I remember going into the bar after a training run and noticing an attractive woman sitting on her own in the bar. That was Claire. Yeah. I actually ignored her, but and then went and started speaking to my friends. And whilst chatting away, a friend of ours from the running club, Sally, who's sitting just over there, she brought this attractive blonde over, which was Claire. And we started talking, and from what I recall, we spoke about various races that Claire had done, including the one marathon at that time, and various other fun runs that she had done. And but then at the end of the evening, we went our separate ways, and I didn't see Claire much after that for a few weeks. But she did decide to join our running club, and over the weeks that followed, we sort of talked more and more, didn't we? And discovered that we had a very similar sense of humour, and that we got on very well. Then shortly after that, I joined Claire's tennis club. So that was another means that we could see each other. One day, I received a text. This was a joke from Claire. A friend of ours had given Claire my mobile number. So from that day on, we texted regularly, and we sent each other sort of jokes and funny messages. And then one day, I got a text message from Claire inviting me to our tennis club dinner and dance. I accepted the invitation and arranged to collect Claire, and we went there together, and we sat at the same table, and the evening went very well. And so as a result of that, I decided to try and pluck up the courage to ask Claire out on a date. Sorry, pause. So I decided to take Claire out for a meal at an Italian restaurant, a local Italian restaurant. And so we had the meal, and the meal seemed to go quite well, and I really enjoyed it. So as we left the restaurant, I turned to Claire and said, I really enjoyed that, you know, did you enjoy it? And now, those of us that know Claire well will know that she likes to speak her mind on many occasions. And on this occasion was one of those occasions. And she turned to me and said, well, that was the worst meal that I've ever had. So, slightly deflated at that moment. She did go on to say that, however, that it was the food that was not very enjoyable, but the company and the evening she did enjoy. So in the weeks and the months that followed, we went out on more dates, and our relationship grew quickly, and we shared some wonderful times and experiences together. And eventually, I plucked up the courage to ask Claire to marry me on the banks of Lake Como in northern Italy. Was there for a 2-week holiday, and I finally.
After I told him.
Yeah. She dropped various hints for the whole fortnight, and this is a romantic setting, yeah. And I finally plucked up the courage on the last evening, and of course she accepted. So as if I doubted anyway, really. So why are we so well suited? Well, in many respects, Claire and I are very similar. We enjoy similar things, we have similar interests, and we want the same things out of life. We do differ in some ways, but we complement each other in these ways. We both have a good sense of humour, and Claire can be tremendously funny, although occasionally without meaning to be. An example of this would be in one of our earlier dates, where we were having a meal in a restaurant in Hampstead, and I called the waitress over and asked for some tomato ketchup, being classy like I am. And Claire looked at me and said, oh, you like ketchup too? We have so much in common. But finally, Claire truly is a wonderful person, and I look forward to sharing our lives together for many wonderful years to come.
Aww.
Just a few more words regarding my new in-laws. I would like to take this opportunity to thank Claire's family for being so welcoming towards me. And I'd like to say how happy I am to become part of the family. And so thank you very much. Just a few words about my parents. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank my mum for being so supportive and strong over the years, particularly the last 2 or 3 years, in which my dad sadly passed away. He's deeply missed. And he would have loved to have been here today, sharing today with us. I'd like to thank my best man, Chris. There was never any doubt that you were going to be the man for the job. Seems I know you're so thorough, and you agree with everything I say. So, but finally, just three toasts that I would like to propose. And the first one will be to the bridesmaids. And thank you all for looking so lovely and doing such a great job. So the toast is to the bridesmaids. Bridesmaids. Yeah, also like to include in that James and Joe as well, who did call their help. They play the role of page boys and general sort of helps. Yeah, so thank you very much. Cheers. The second toast is to my wife, Claire. So please raise a glass to my wife, Claire. Cheers. And the final toast is to absent friends, and this obviously includes my dad, Tony, and Claire's mum and dad, Joe and Mary. So the toast is to absent friends. I will now pass you over to my brother and best man. Thank you.
Well, good evening, everyone. On behalf of Claire, the bridesmaids, and the helpers and ushers, I'd like to thank Adrian for his toast, so thank you very much on their behalf. We have a video message that we'll play a little bit later on, I think, before the music starts. We've got a video message, a lovely message from Bernadette Durkin and daughters. So I think that'll be shown on the screen at the end of the marquee. I should like to add to the thanks to Andrew, Caroline, Geraldine and Tom, which Adrian has already expressed on this wonderful and delightful occasion, and toast them in particular. So be upstanding once more. Grab your glass. Hopefully you haven't run out yet of champagne. Yeah, so to a toast to Andrew and Caroline, Geraldine and Tom. So thanks for all their hard work. Also, I think a round of applause. You haven't got to stand for this. He'll be happy about it. He'll be sitting down for the next 20 or 30 minutes whilst I go through my speech. Oh, I thought that's what he wanted. Right? I think the round of applause, not just purely because they're the bride and groom, but because they've been so generous and amiable and so kind over the last few weeks in the way they've arranged their own wedding with the support of their family. But they've been very, very generous and warm-hearted all the way through. So a round of applause for a fantastic couple. And I don't know whether, Andy, when you went through the names of people, but did you mention the people that are doing the washing up? Have you mentioned them by name? Did you mention them by name? Yeah, so there's a whole team of people down in the main part of the house there that have been washing away for the last probably 6 or 7 days. I suppose. Yeah. So a round of applause for the washer-uppers. Excellent job. Now, this is the fourth time I've stood up today from a warm seat with a piece of damp paper in my hand, so you have to excuse me for that. Not that I'm nervous or anything. You'll be pleased to know that when it comes to speeches, I've taken the view that less is more. Okay, less is more. Actually, I used that on their wedding night, didn't I? I said, so you didn't want exactly the same as Thursday, did you? Yeah, we got all the saucy ones here tonight. It doesn't get any worse than that, you'd be happy to know. I've been told that the best speech makers follow three simple rules. That's stand up, speak up, and then quickly shut up. So only 2 more minutes to go. I'll stick to that advice. For those who don't know me, I'm Chris, Adrian's older brother. that when Adrian and I lived with our mum and dad some 20 odd years ago, it was his job from time to time to do the cooking, and my job to go from room to room removing the batteries from the smoke alarms. So I built up a bit of legwork up and down the stairs doing that. But Adrian has become more domesticated recently, so it must be love. So, yeah. And he is now seen roaming the aisles of the supermarkets, even if he forgets to take money with him from time to time. So he's done that twice. We grew up together, always getting on, and shared several hobbies, including playing the bugle. And Adrian still teaches the bugle at our BB band night. And latterly, we share the hobby of running. I distinctly remember running up a hill, this is true, looking over my shoulder over at Hilly Field a few years back, and Adrian was struggling up the hill. And it was while we were trying to improve our running that Adrian joined the Trent Park Running Club, and that is where he met Claire. And the rest is history. Now he leaves me behind on the hills and on the flat as well. So a bit of a gazelle running around Enfield. Other skills Adrian has, which you may or may not know, include tool making. He did a 4-year apprenticeship from the age of 16, become a highly skilled tool maker. Then went into computer aided design, and then went on to welding, and has done some classic car restoration, so very talented there. In fact, I think there's a couple of pictures on the screen of Adrian working on his car. He studied art, and became a good painter and sketcher. In fact, he's such a good painter, I think, could he come and do my emulsion in my loft conversion over the next few weeks? Gonna need all hands on deck for that. And more recently, he's moved into a new career, into land searches and studying the art of management now with ILM Level 5. So he's working very hard in his new career. He also got quite good at the guitar some years back, so who knows, you might pick up the guitar and start learning that again in the future. I think Claire looks... You didn't look too... Yeah. Well, a few more beers, yeah. He'll be grabbing my guitar. I'd like to thank, before I carry on, also Paul and his dad Ian for helping us. I think Paul's over that table there for helping us arrange the stag day, which was watching a few games of polo. And we did have a curry and a beer. We came back to Enfield and had a curry and a few beers. Anyway, the day has arrived for this fantastic reception, and what a day so far. Now, wedding brings together a couple, Adrian and Claire, who have chosen to share the rest of their lives together. But it also brings together two families, the Marlowes and Quinlivans. And I hope that not only Adrian and Claire's lives are enriched by their marriage, but also the families can get to know each other as well. And we look forward to that. Now, a few years back, Adrian went through a difficult time with his career, and this was made all the more difficult by the loss of our dad. And as we lost a loved one, it seemed that Claire came into Adrian and our lives, and our lives have been all the better for it. I really, really mean that. The first time we met Claire, Laura, myself and our two daughters, was at our church. Adrian brought Claire along to our church. And we all recognised at an early stage that not only was Claire a very family-orientated person, but also a very good both for and to Adrian. We could see that in the early days. Claire is a caring and loving and faithful companion for Adrian and has an endearing character, which has enriched all our family. She's also very hardworking, often working long hours, and she knows how to enjoy herself. So much so, she's encouraged Adrian. She's encouraged Adrian. No, only a weekend this is. She's also encouraged Adrian to let his hair down. although you could say that his hair has let him down. Likewise me, so I'm probably the only one or two people in this room that can say that joke. Anyway, on Thursday, I ended on a few words from William Shakespeare. But this evening, I'd like to end with an Indian proverb. It goes like this. When love reigns, the impossible may be attained. When love reigns, the impossible may be attained. But you may well ask yourself, okay, well, what is love? Well, in my opinion, from the most popular and important book ever written, we hear that love is patient, it's kind, it protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. So for Adrian and Claire, they will achieve great and wonderful things in their wedding life when love reigns. So I propose a toast, be upstanding, to Claire and Adrian. Enduring love, health and happiness to Claire and Adrian. Thank you, everyone.
A little bit actually.